Hello, hello, and welcome back to another video. How you guys doing today? So good to be back. Even more delightful is the fact that we are on the Dead Cat microphone, which actually captures good audio. Thank you. Thank you, buddy. Which actually captures great audio, not just a bunch of garbled wind noise. Even though I can hear the wind, and there's plenty of it, and it's loud, and it's obnoxious when it's on video. For the videos, which I love to watch as well, it's nice audio, subtle wind noise, subtle car noise, subdued, relaxing, and good, clear, quality vocal. I had such a great experience with my first video with the new Dead Cat microphone. And when I say Dead Cat, I'm talking about it's the special name for the texture of the microphone cover. It's kind of furry. I was so excited about that first upload that I had to just move it straight to the front of the line and put it up immediately just to show everyone what I was so excited and happy about. And now I think I'm just gonna have to upload all the newest videos first and just get the sweet audio collection of videos straight to the front of the line. And I don't know, I guess maybe even discard the old videos or voice them over or something, or put some kind of soundtrack over them. But I don't know about ever uploading bad audio videos again. It's like once you have a good once you have a taste of some good videos with good audio, it's like, whew, yes, I want to ride all day. And oh, look at this, an obstruction. Go ahead, I'll hold your bike. Yeah, that's no good. My man, thank you. Thank you. That's a good Samaritan right there. Hey, he stopped. He could have just went around the box, but he stopped and picked it up and moved it over. Not just for the fellow bikers, wheelers, boarders, but also for the cars. That's right. Even a car wouldn't really want to drive over a gigantic mystery box. It's funny too, because you might think it's empty and go right through it, and then imagine it's like heavy and like there's stuff in there. That'd be terrible. All right. Sometimes my recording contraption feels like a katana sword. Like I could be like, yeah, and just switch it up and bring it around and swing it overhead. Yes, give me the angles. Sweet views and carbs. It's like, what is there not to love about riding your EDC up and around? Okay, so let's do some updates on the helmet now that we seem to have figured out the microphone issue. Let me explain a couple things. Number one, I love this helmet because it's the second version of the helmet that I loved so much the first time around, and that's the helmet you guys are used to seeing me with. It's the helmet that I've been using for a while now, even since back in my scooter days, riding the Wolf Warrior. Yeah, that guy's cutting it close. He's pushing the limits there. So it's the second version, so the design style is pretty close to the old one, okay? With some updates. It looks a little more teched out, like some more air vents and some cooler design slices. Okay, so there's that. But that's not enough to make me want to upgrade. So why did I upgrade? Okay, well, there's another thing. Ooh, police officers are stopping bicycles down there. I'm not going for that. He's making that person get off their bike. That's tough. Not sure what's going on there. Anyway, everyone seems to have made a right over here. Everyone seems to have made a right and said, nope. And the police officers looked like they were jumping back in their cars because they were like, oh, no, you don't. You're not escaping justice from us today. I wonder if they saw me on the electric unicycle and were like, oh, we've got one. I think they usually go for the moped, but they literally had a bicycle stopped. An actual bicycle. They didn't even look like an electric bike either. I don't know what that's all about. That's kind of a tough pick. Anyway. Yeah. Okay, what was I saying? I'm gonna definitely get this point across. I'm not gonna forget what I was talking about. Ooh. BMW stranded. Oh, no one in there. That's interesting. That's an interesting place to stop. He really gave himself some room back there, too. Whoa, windy. Whoa, I almost just got blown off the wheel. Okay, so a couple things about the helmet. Let's see if I can give you the short version rather than the long version, because I can get long-winded about stuff like this. So the helmet. It's version 2.0, same helmet, same company, same manufacturer, rather, same brand. But this, like, literally they titled it, like, the second iteration of that helmet. Okay, so why did I upgrade then? Why do I need a slight modification in design? That was not the only upgrade I needed. It all started when I decided that I would like to have Bluetooth in my helmet. So I ordered a Bluetooth upgrade kit. And then from there, when I tried to put it in my current helmet at the time, which was the older version of this one, that helmet was a size large, and that large sized helmet was not big enough to support a Bluetooth upgrade kit where you have to put these little ear headphone piece items inside the helmet and still get your head on the helmet. Once I put those pieces inside the helmet, they were about I want to say close to a centimeter thick. And there was no way that helmet was going on my head. It was so tight. It was already tight without the Bluetooth upgrade. So I was already skeptical, but I thought, hey, maybe, you know, maybe there's a design thing in there where it, like, fits into a slot. Or maybe it doesn't get in the way. It's, like, kind of by the ears, and maybe there's more room by the ears. I justified it to myself in so many different ways. So I just took a crack at it. And, of course, I thought to myself, well, if it doesn't work, I'll just return it. You know, Amazon's good, etc. So I order the thing and I'm like, whoa, heck no, that thing is crushing my skull. I can't even get the helmet on my head with the Bluetooth upgrade. So I go online and I'm like, you know what? I'm going to stay true to the brand and I'm going to order the same helmet in size extra large, XL instead of L. So I'm like, that should be enough room. Since I can fit a size large on my head, I should be able to fit the X large and the earpieces that go for the Bluetooth upgrade. Boom, problem solved. And I'm like, you know, even though it's $100+ for the new helmet, I just really want the same helmet and I want the Bluetooth. So, you know, I'm like, it's worth it. I'll figure out a way to offset the cost. I'll sell the old one or something, or I'll give it away to someone who needs it. And I've had it for a couple of years anyway, so I kind of got my value out of it already anyway, if I must give it up for free. So I'm like, all right, I ordered the X-Large, it comes in. I try to put the helmet on without the Bluetooth, just to put it on my head, and it's tighter than the large. I must have broken in the large or something, because the large one fit on my head. It's tight, but it fit. But the X-Large didn't even fit. I could barely even get it on my head. I could barely even get it on my head. So I'm like, oh boy. Immediately I hit the return button. I pack everything back up where it was. And I go online again. I start looking around. Again, I want the same helmet. So I'm looking for double XL. So I type in the brand of helmet and I put in double XL. And what pops up, this other helmet, this one, which to me looked almost the same. And then I noticed that it's the same brand. And I noticed that, oh, I look at the model number, it's like almost the same model number. And then finally in the description, I realized they are claiming that this is the second version of that helmet. And they have it available in double XL. So I'm like, okay, bingo. I have more hopes. I'm not super hopeful because even XL was still pretty tight. But I'm like, I'm hopeful enough to try it. So I order the helmet. Oh, and I'm looking at the description. I don't want to scream because these pigeons. Sorry, brother. They'll come back. So here's the other thing I do. I look at the description and it literally says Bluetooth upgradable, and it shows like these little circles where like these the exact same Bluetooth upgrade earpieces, the speaker set, fit exactly in those carved out circles from the helmet. They actually have a spot in there designed specifically for those Bluetooth earmuffs or those earpieces. So I'm like, oh boy, that's super helpful. So not only is it an X large, but it's also gonna have the Bluetooth upgradability ready to go. So I order it, I put it on as soon as it comes in the mail, and lo and behold, perfect. My head slides right in. It's not too tight, it's not too loose. It's definitely looser and more space, and the helmet looks huge. As soon as I see it out of the box, double XL, and I hold the helmet in my hand, I'm like, whoa, this thing is gonna make me look like one of those bobblehead dolls or something. Like, this thing's gigantic, which I don't mind. I don't mind how that looks. Having a giant helmet head appearance is fine by me. I think they already look huge and almost silly, like, but I don't mind. I think it looks cool. I don't mind it being even bigger. No problem. Fine by me. So I'm looking at the design. I'm like, oh, this is great. I see the slots. So I'm like, all right, next step, time to outfit it with the Bluetooth. I set up the Bluetooth. It even has the Velcro material needed for the ear pad thingies to stick inside the helmet. And the antenna even slips right through behind the, not the antenna, the microphone stick piece, the piece that, here, let me show you. Right here, see this thing? It's got like the power button, fast forward button, rewind button, and it's flexible, and it fits perfectly along the bottom edge of the helmet. So I'm like, ooh, excellent. And it fits, everything's good. I get everything underneath the padding inside the helmet, so it's all very seamless. So when you hold the helmet and look inside, you don't see any wires or any Bluetooth headset pieces or anything like that. And to turn it on and off is super simple. So I'm like, oh great, this is wonderful. I put it on, I go outside with it, I try it out around the house. I even get like this inner helmet liner, this like head armor cloth thing that you put it on before you put on your helmet, just to keep you like cooler and like to keep all your hair and stuff from like getting all up in the helmet. It's just like a barrier, like a layer that you wear, like almost like wearing an undershirt before you put on your shirt. So great, I'm loving the helmet. It fits good, it feels good, it feels better than the other helmet. It's cool, I've got more space here on the side of my nose. My nose used to rub against the other helmet sometime. And then even better still is the glass that goes up and down, this visor thing. It looks just as black as the old one, which I love, because I like the black look of the helmet all around. But when I put on the helmet, it looks clear. Like right now, as I'm looking at the camera and looking at the street and the sky, it looks clear. It doesn't look tinted at all. The other one looks really tinted. It's so black that it's good and when it's sunny out, because it's like it really mitigates like the beam of the sun. But you can't wear it at night because then everything's too dark. You really can't even see. But this one, you can see even at night, and during the day it blocks out the sun, and I can still see everything very clearly. It doesn't look that dark at all. I used to have to pull up the visor sometimes before on the old helmet, just so I can see the bumps. If I'm going to ride fast or something, I would actually pull it up for a second just to get a better look at the road, because I felt like the dark black would obstruct my view a little bit and stuff. So I would, you know, I don't have to do that anymore. And now it like protects me from the dust and stuff. I can leave it on all the time. And it's more room in the helmet. So I like don't feel like the fog and all that happening. It's like feels a lot cooler. Doesn't feel like it's super tight and hot in there as it did with the smaller helmet, with the smaller large. So now I got all the room that I need. I've got the Bluetooth built in. And there's one more thing now, and this was the most troublesome, which is the microphone. You see this microphone I have connected to the strap right here? Well, I put it on and I start recording my videos, and my videos sound so windy. I cannot, ooh, a fellow EUC rider. Let's see if I can catch up to him. It sounds so windy in the videos. I'm like, oh no, this helmet's no good, because I'm thinking it's so big down here that I can't even, you know, get the microphone situated in a way where it's not going to give me a bunch of wind noise. Hey, fellow EUC rider, what's up, man? Hey, man. How you doing?
Good,
All right, what you got there?
V8S.
Oh, that's a goodie right there.
Yeah, I'm looking for an upgrade though. What do you have there?
Sherman. This is an OG Sherman.
Oh, nice.
That's a V8S or F?
S.
Oh, S. That's a goodie. Man, you upgraded that already, huh?
Yeah, it was my first one.
Uh-huh.
It was on sale, and I figured this is the one that gives me a little bit more range, right?
Yeah, right. And it gave you a lot of learning, and I see you got some very nice knee pads.
Yeah.
Good helmet on.
Pretty, so.
Good, man. That's a very nimble, quick wheel. Even if you get an upgrade, you're going to want to hang on to that wheel.
Is that right?
Absolutely, because there's, like, local errands and the quick wheel.
Yeah.
Are you going?
Yeah.
We can walk and talk a little if you want.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I keep a 16S around, an 18S, like, you know, friends and family, kids and stuff, people ride. But you want to keep a small wheel, even if you get like a Sherman or something.
Right.
What are you looking for an upgrade? Which wheel?
I'm torn from like getting a suspension
wheel. A suspension wheel?
Or like even like a Sherman, I guess.
A Sherman Max is what you want, I think. I think you want a Sherman Max, in my opinion. I mean, even if I upgraded the Sherman, I'd probably go for the Sherman Max.
And you feel all right with all the bumps and everything?
I do, because I've gotten used to it. I just bend my knees and kind of take in the bumps as they come. But I don't know that I would go for a suspension unless I got a Sherman S, perhaps.
Yeah.
But even then, they're just so big and heavy, and the maintenance. Like, I had to change my tire, which is something you're going to expect to have to do at some point or another.
Right.
And even for this very supposedly simple wheel, it was incredibly arduous. It was not an easy task. It was not for the faint hearted. Not even for everybody. And I can only imagine a complicated suspension wheel with all kinds of pressure to worry about. I'm just thinking, if I get a suspension wheel, it's going to be a wheel that I'm going to use for one full round before maintenance. And then that's it. I'm not doing maintenance on that. It's so many parts and so much sensitivity.
Yeah.
To assembling and disassembling.
So you do just for commuting, I guess?
I rebuilt this from scratch after my accident, so I can deal with this. And the performance and all that, great. As far as suspension, I mean, if you're older or if you have knee problems or anything like that,
yeah.
I could see you really wanting the suspension. But if not, if you can handle it, like for me, like you see these bumps, it's kind of the same, unless you really catch a hard edge and crack your rim. Otherwise, you really don't have to worry too much about it. Even unexpected power. I mean, I've caught air. I've been up in the air from some unexpected.
And the pads help, I assume, because I see you got power pads on.
Yeah, for sure. Power pads are huge, very important on bigger wheels. But on a wheel like that, I mean, you're good. You can excel. You can beep that wheel out all day with no pads, so.
Yeah, my only thing with me is not having the pads is that if I catch air, I feel like I lose.
Yes.
Totally off. And I don't have, like, I have the regular.
Yeah.
It's like you've got, like, the studs and stuff that make me.
Right, right. Yeah, I mean, even if you catch air on that, you're moving the same speed as the wheel, so you'll still land on the pedal. Like, you can catch full air. I was actually riding this wheel for 1,000 miles with no pads at all. But what happened is it was putting too much strain on my ankles and my feet to leverage the wheel. But when you put the pads on, you kind of spread that leveraging all the way up to your calves and legs, so it helps.
Yeah.
So you don't get so much strain in your feet, which actually after some time was starting to get really bad. I was getting cramps in my feet.
Uh-huh.
So I felt the like unhealthy effects of it.
Got it.
But so that's why I kind of caved on the pads. Even though I felt like a purist, I was really proud of the no pads. Actually, I think it was deteriorating my health and my feet, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's eventually, and I love the Grizzly pad. So if you're going to keep it simple, and you're going to go all the way in, you're just going to want that Sherman Max.
Sorry,
it's okay, it's okay. You're just going to want a Sherman Max. I mean, with some nice pads like these, you're good to go. With a little bit of accessories, and then just get a lot of miles under your belt so that when you're riding, you're not really depending on the suspension. You're depending on more on your experience and your miles and things like that.
Is that your first wheel?
No, this is like my 10th wheel, maybe.
When did you start with the...
I started with actually a Segway S2, if you really want to go back. And then I got a King Song 16S. And then and then the Sherman, but then a whole lot of wheels in between buying and selling.
Yeah.
But the Sherman stuck and the 16S stuck. I keep those two wheels no matter what. Everything else comes and goes. I mean, my opinion might change down the line if I really have a great suspension wheel. I understand that. But right now, after having tried a little bit of suspension and reading people's feelings about it, I think I'm good so far.
I'm curious which of you tried.
So I've had a few S18s, which are suspension wheels. Yeah. Granted, not that powerful, but you know, powerful enough. You go 30 miles an hour on that thing, and you can really feel the suspension there. I've tried a few suspension wheels from friends, and then I've had a bunch of wheels like the Nikola, an MSX, a bunch of other wheels. I really can't even remember all of them offhand, but a bunch of wheels that in the end, I just felt like the Sherman was it. There's really no reason to have any other wheel. The Sherman and the 16S was good for when I need to throw it in the trunk or ride the train. I would just pick it up and go.
Yeah. I've been on the subway with this.
Yeah.
It was helpful because I could carry it up and down.
Correct. Yeah, because sometimes with the Sherman, you don't want to do a 10-mile ride. So you'll take the 16S just so that you can get off at a pretty convenient stop so that you don't have to transfer to like three different trains. You'll take one train, you know, you'll ride to the train maybe a mile or two. And when you get down, when you get off down there, you'll ride from that stop for a mile or two. And then you just save like half an hour off of an hour long journey just by doing that. So if you're strategic about it, you can really hack the system, you know?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Now what do you do? How long is your commute?
Usually about 3 to 4 miles each way, which for the Sherman is like, to me, that's lovely. That's perfect.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want to do 10 miles or whatever.
I do this 10 miles.
10 miles each way?
Yeah.
Each way?
So I
oh, you're a beast.
Like
10. Oh, so yeah. I mean, honestly, the more miles you have, the more you're exposed to risk. So I don't even know that you want to be on a Sherman doing 30, 40 miles an hour.
Yeah.
This is more steady and cool, kind of cool headed. So it's like... But, you know, I mean, you're going to want power at some point. Yeah. Here and there, if there's a stretch.
Yeah, I'm probably going to kill this battery soon. So
I'm yeah, right. But you're putting some miles on it. And then you do some leisure riding or no?
Not a whole lot. Just because I
don't you know, don't need to. You're getting your fill off the commute.
Yeah.
Yeah. But my friend just got the V8S from Amazon, and he just loves it. He's riding it all over. He's also thinking about getting a Sherman or a suspension wheel. And up to this point so far, he's fully satisfied. He's like, I'm thinking about it, but I haven't really worn out the V8S, like, desire-wise.
Yeah, no, I got this through Amazon because it was on sale for, like, under $1,000.
Oh, sweet. Like, that's a great price.
So I got it like last summer.
That's like 12, maybe 14, 1600, right?
I think it's usually retail for like 1300.
13, yeah. Yeah.
So it was a nice sale.
Oh, so less than 1,000 is a great steal. That's why you want to keep that. You want to just keep it and just have that as your. And that beats most modern electric skateboards, scooters at 20, 25 maybe, right?
Yeah. I'll max at 22.
22 is not bad. That's just enough to keep you, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I
kind of want to
go.
Oh, yeah. You're beeping it. It's telling you to slow down. Yeah. Well, you're getting there. If you're putting enough miles on it, you start to get comfortable. You're going to want to actually put some speed on it. But
with the Sherman, you feel stable at my place.
Oh, it's the most stable. You know? The Sherman, I mean, if you break 40 miles an hour, you feel fine on it. Yeah. And then there's the InMotion V12. The speed model does 43, but from what I've heard, 43 on that 16-inch thin wheel, no way. It's wobbly, it's unsafe. Yeah, I had a V11 as well. Oh, you're here?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I've had a V11 as well, and I didn't even ride it more than a couple of times. I don't know that I'd recommend the V11 because it's a very... Nice. Oh, that's a cool scooter. Look at this guy. It's nice, bro. A V11 is also, it's just very refined. It's just too clean. It's not really a rough and tough kind of. The suspension is also is finicky. People are talking about they constantly have to refill the air.
And you have to like unscrew the thing.
Yeah.
I was reading about that.
And it's like it gets imbalanced, and you have to make sure they're both the same PSI. It's a whole thing. This is why I was telling you in general suspension for me. I'm kind of like, I like to just get on and go for months and months.
As long as you get used to bending your knees.
Yes. It's almost like, you know Guitar Hero?
Yeah,
you have to flick it right when the thing comes.
Yeah.
It's like that. As long as you see it coming and right when you get to it, you're ready for it. It's like, it's almost like a game. To me, it's a little more fun. I would actually miss the idea of like, yeah, so it's something to consider. I mean, because I have fun riding too. I don't just ride to get around only. But hey, man, pleasure meeting you. Yeah, ride safe and be careful and good luck with your next wheel.
All right, thank you.
My man.
Good input, appreciate it.
All right, thank you. I appreciate it. No problem. Anytime. Have a great day, brother. Always keep an eye out for traffic. Oh, what a nice guy. Young riders in the mix, huh? Yeah, you don't always meet a fellow young rider, but it's nice. A budding starting out rider who's only been on it for a few months, enjoying the EUC journey. Very interesting. Nice to hear their opinions and see what they think of it. Even though I think I was the one sharing my opinion the most, but anyway, this video will be over shortly. I'm going to head back up towards whence I came. Pardon, thank you. And knowing that the microphone is with me and it's on and it's, you know, it's got the dead cat on it so you can hear me clearly, just give me a lot more reassurance to ride. I need water. It's giving me a lot of reassurance to ride longer and enjoy and let the video be as long as I want. Thank you, pardon. So that's nice. Like, I don't, it's not that I want to ride longer, but it's like, I don't feel bad. I don't feel like it's too long or the video is getting to be too long when it's getting long. I just kind of enjoy it and so be it. But if it's like, it's bad audio, I get a little tense and it's like, I'm getting a little anxious. I want to end it and make sure I just call it quits before it drags out. I'm going to close the visor because I think all this air is like drying out my throat, making me thirsty. Also, I gotta answer the phone. I don't know if you heard it, but it kept ringing. So I'm gonna figure out what's happening there. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, the helmet thing. Yeah, so the helmet was allowing air in, and I was blaming the helmet because it was logical to me that it was the helmet's fault that I couldn't get good vocal audio anymore recorded, because I had the same audio equipment on the other helmet and I could hear my voice fine in the videos, and now I have this new helmet and the voice is terrible and it keeps getting in wind no matter what, even though I'm doing the same thing. I'm putting the microphone in the same spot, so I'm like, okay, it's a bigger helmet, air is getting in there, that's what's happening. So what happens, I'm like sharing my concerns on the channel and a bunch of you guys chime in. And some of my friends are texting me, calling me, saying, hey, I can't hear anything. The wind noise is insufferable. And I agree, because I'm watching the videos too. And I'm like, ugh, I'm going to enjoy the visual and I'm just going to mute it. But I don't want to hear extremely loud wind noise in my living room on the TV. At least not all the time, maybe sometimes. But so it became a real point of contention. I tried like 7 different solutions. And I guess I was barking up the wrong tree on some of those solutions, because it turns out that the dead cat little furry, you can probably see it right here, the little furry wind cover thing did a great job. I recorded a video the other day. I recorded a video the other day and it worked well. I watched it and I was like almost in tears. I think that's what I called it. And the reason why I called it that is because at some point during the video I said something about unleashing sweet video glory and uploading a lot if I got the sound issue resolved. And so there it was. There you had it. I was doing that video not even fully sure if the issue was resolved yet. So I was kind of talking and hoping. But rewatching that video and seeing that it was coming through fine and crisp was moving. It was really touching. Ooh, my throat feels better after that terrible cough. So sorry you had to pay for the price of that, but at least now I feel better, right? Hey, so I also blamed the fact that there's like almost a millimeter of space right here between the helmet line and the mask of the helmet. So I was like, oh, that must be the problem. It must be because of that tiny little sliver opening. Actually, and the opening was bigger before, but I got managed to like unhook it or something. It was like stuck. And so now it's like only less than a millimeter. But before it was like 2-3 millimeters. So I'm thinking, okay, this whole thing is defective. But honestly, now that the sound is working well and the helmet's closed all the way, even if there is like almost a millimeter or whatever of space, I'm okay with that. I'm satisfied because it's not like there's wind coming in and there's no dust coming in and blinding me or anything like that. It's as long as I have the visor down, it's protecting my face. No air is coming in. I don't hear any air. I don't see anything. Everything's fine. I can live with... I'm going to actually look again to make sure that I'm not just imagining that there's an opening. Make sure that there really is. And even if so, I'm not going to return the helmet as long as the noise issue is fully resolved and it doesn't persist. I think I'm happy with everything now. And that's the transition journey going from... the phase of video making that I was at to this current phase and towards the next phase and onwards towards the phase after that, and we shall keep rising and going up in quality and value until we reach new heights together as a family and work our way through the different levels and the heights. Anyway, let me stop. Yep, folks, if you're enjoying this video, like, subscribe, comment, share, watch, enjoy, analyze. I think that's all the verbs I can muster. Whoa, I'm gonna slow down because these metal grates, I'm pretty sure some of them are pretty high and can bust my rim open. I'm not trying to break a rim, it takes so much work. I hope you enjoyed today's very long video. And if you did, let me know. And if not, let me know what I can do better, or let me know what you didn't enjoy so I can be on the lookout. I appreciate you tuning in. I'll see all of you very soon on the next one. Have a great day. Goodbye.